Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Well, let's actually get to Keith's question. Now, in yesterday's netcast, I showed how we could use indirect to grab values from various worksheets in the current workbook. But Keith has the completely different problem. Every day, his sales are saved to a new workbook. So he has workbooks, for example, called Sales 2008-08-07. And there'll be a different workbook for every day. And he needs a VLOOKUP that's going to go grab the right workbook and find the value and return the value. Well, that's just not going to work. We have indirect. Well, there's a couple of problems. Indirect cannot look into a closed workbook. So what Keith would have to do, here on my second sheet, is actually keep all of those workbooks open, which probably is not realistic. And so what we're going to do is we're going to use a great function that was written by Harlan Grove. Now, you can just go out to Google and search for Harlan Grove Pull, and you'll get to the code. It's posted in several different places. I took that code and I pasted it into Excel as a new user function called Pull. And the way the Pull works is basically I set up a concatenation here that builds the file name. So we have our date over in column A. In column C, I used the text function, like we did yesterday, to convert that to the correct format. Build the file name here, the worksheet name, sheet 1 all the time, and then the range where we want to look up. And then finally, the pull function. Basically, the pull function becomes the second argument in VLOOKUP. So we pull the opening apostrophe, the file name, the worksheet name, the closing apostrophe, the bang character, the exclamation mark, and the range name. That function will go out and open the file or return the whole array to Excel. Now, it's a bit slow. It would work here if I'm just pulling one or two values from each worksheet for 30 days, but if you were looking up hundreds or thousands of these, the recap time would be impossible. But if you have a few, great way to do this using Harlan Grove's pull function. Well, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.